So SARP is the Student Airborne Research Program, and what's really exciting about SARP is we tend to find students who are at smaller universities who might not have access to research opportunities within their university, and we give them what I consider like a once in a lifetime chance to come out, see how scientists within NASA, NOAA, some of our other government agencies, different universities, collect data on flying laboratories.
I'm from a very small town in southwestern Pennsylvania, from a college called Penn West University of California. And whenever I say small, I mean like very small. There's only like 7 to 8 people in my class. I major in meteorology and climate science. So it's a very, very small university. So I'm very proud to be able to say that I got into this.
Hey, the acetone seems like it's at a pretty high level right now. Is anybody else noticing that?
We are there to learn. We are there to observe, see what's going on with the scientists, learn about the tools and instrumentation firsthand, personal, ask any questions we have, things that we can't find online, things that you couldn't typically research. We have the expert in front of us to ask those questions to.
Julia, you see that black valve right there? Can you turn that 90 degrees?
Out or in?
That way, yes. Thank you.
This year we have the whole air sampling group, we have the atmospheric aerosols group, we have the land group, and we have the oceans group. So those are pretty broad, research topics. But what's really cool is the students, they get assigned into these groups randomly.
I'm a geologist, I'm on the ground, I love the earth, and they put me in a group with air. And so they do that and it makes us really interdisciplinary. I had so many project ideas for the land, and throwing me into the air group, I'm having to learn about all these things I wouldn't typically study with my degree plan and incorporate them into the field that I do love.
Because of the way that this program works, dividing us into 4 different groups, you're thrown into areas that you're very unfamiliar with. So being able to explore all these different things, as a geologist, being up in the air looking at aerosol chemistry, I don't think would ever have crossed my mind. Being able to take in new experiences and adapt that into my form of knowledge and understanding of the world helps create these wonderful discoveries that are going to change the world.
And on top of that, they're extremely excited to teach you about everything that they know. They're excited to see the future, and we are the future.
In terms of my future, who knows, maybe I'll be back in this facility sometime.